Welcome back to Executive Class, in our episode on what industry insiders and observers call the comeback of corporate travel. Indeed, like the phenomenon of revenge travel for leisure, business travel is making a comeback. And though it's not quite at pre-pandemic levels yet, businessmen are booking rooms, joining events, and yes, taking to the skies once again. All business travelers aspire, even dream of having their own private aircraft. And let's face it, one brand in particular, Gulfstream, which is both top of class and top of mind when it comes to private business aviation. Now we're here to check out their latest aircraft, the G500, which Gulfstream calls a clean sheet design. The G500 is the latest generation in a line of business jets developed by the world's leading manufacturer in private business aircraft, and a brand synonymous with exclusivity, luxury, and cutting-edge aviation technology. The G500 is not the largest Gulfstream. In fact, it falls right in the middle of the full range of Gulfstream aircraft. If one think about it, this is the latest generation of this aircraft over here, the G450. Which we've learned to love so much. We've flown in the G450 many times in the past and enjoyed the smoothness, the silence, and the superior cabin space and comfort each and every time. So we were curious to know how the Gulfstream G500's new design and avionics improves on what's already considered the gold standard in regional VIP business travel. Safer, faster, and more fuel efficient. That's what the design of the G500 is all about. But apart from that, the design is also optimized to allow the plane to land on shorter runways. So if you're a local business traveler, you know that's exactly what you need in this country. Of course, there are other Gulfstream jets available, although the company is introducing updated models across the model range. For now, for long distance and intercontinental flights, the top-of-the-line G650ER, we reviewed some years back, remains a top choice. For short hops and inter-island travel, the mid-sized G150 is likewise a popular and relatively economical choice among those who fly solo or in smaller parties. The G500, on the other hand, is perfect for regional travel and can fly up to 19 people non-stop to anywhere in and around Asia, from Manila to Dubai, or Manila to Hawaii. Just another hop and you're in Europe, or mainland America. And at a maximum speed of 0.925 Mach, much faster at that. I was given an exclusive and technical tour of the aircraft by Gulfstream Aerospace pilot Eric Henman at the Asian Aerospace Hangar in Naia recently. And though I've always been impressed with Gulfstream jets, this new generation aircraft is on a different level entirely, not just in terms of cabin comforts and amenities which have been upgraded thoroughly, but where it matters most to pilots like Eric and the flight deck of the cockpit. Gulfstream's Symmetry flight deck is at the heart of the clean sheet design pioneered in the G500 Gulfstream. It offers a radically different, yet safer and simpler way to fly a plane, as I'll try to explain after Captain Eric's lengthy demonstration. So, now that we're done with our quick tour of the aircraft with Captain Eric, let me just dwell a bit longer inside the cabin and enjoy some of the highlights of the G500. Many of the best features aren't entirely brand new, mostly improvements such as these larger panoramic oval windows, which I've always loved in the Gulfstream. The G500 remains a full stand-up cabin, although it's much wider than the G450, its predecessor. There's a lot more space, as you can see. And speaking of space, the G500 can seat up to 19 passengers and sleep, full flat, for 8. But of course,
it's all up to the customer to configure and customize the cabin for even more space and comfort.
The seat design and controls have been upgraded as well. And as for the number of seats, their layout, even the leather, it's all up to you and your imagination.
Now, if that looks comfortable, wait till you see this. Well, actually, that's not all, because this can be configured to be a full flat bed. And since we're discussing passenger comfort, let's talk about the air quality inside the cabin. Unlike with commercial aircraft where the air is merely recycled throughout the journey, inside the G500, 100% fresh air is pumped every 2 minutes inside the cabin. Plus, it's got ionization. Fatigue, drowsiness, and hardness of breathing is quite normal when flying commercial aircraft. And that's because of the high cabin altitude. Now, the G500 is optimized for what they call low cabin altitude, which means that instead of like feeling you're flying 43,000 feet up in the air, which you are, it feels more like just 3,000 feet. That's like standing on top of a tall building. This is really amazing. Passenger comfort is really top-notch in a Gulfstream. But of course, a lot of this isn't entirely new. In fact, you'll find these features in many of the top-of-the-line Gulfstream aircraft. Now, what's really new, however, or should I say revolutionary, is what they've done with the flight deck. So let's go back inside and see what's changed and how aviation, private business aviation, is changing.
Although I'm not a pilot or aviation geek, even I can tell that the G500 Symmetry flight deck is nothing short of revolutionary, more so for those in the pilot seats. Gone is the usual array and often confusing banks of toggles, dials, and switches, and in its place, 10 touchscreen displays, a new way of designing controls to enhance safety, operational efficiency, and redundancy. Gone too is a traditional yoke pilots use to maneuver the plane. To increase visual and tactile feedback between pilots and the flight deck, the G500 introduces active control side sticks for the very first time in a civilian jet. Another new safety feature is the Enhanced Flight Vision System that allows pilots to land in low visibility conditions. While the new Synthetic Vision Primary Flight Display, featuring 3D graphics of terrain and runways, helps boost the pilot's situational awareness.
Now, in a scenario where something goes wrong with the controls, which happens a lot with other aircraft, instead of grounding the plane or delaying the flight and waiting for this to be repaired, which could take hours, if not even days, well, this touchscreen control can be replaced with any one of the other ones inside the cabin. It's out quick.
Indeed, this new swappable touchscreen control technology will probably impress pilots and owners of the aircraft most. Less downtime equals less flight delays, which equals more savings in time and money. Speaking of which, $50 million for a brand new G500 is a lot of money. But Paige Rodriguez of Asian Aerospace, the authorized international sales representative of Gulfstream in the Philippines, walks me through the various costs and benefits of ownership.
So if you're going to use it something like maybe once a year, twice a year, then you're better off chartering. But maybe you want it just so it's there and ready for any time you need it. Next, if you're going to fly it like weekly or every other week, you need to go somewhere, then perfect. You need an aircraft for yourself.
And if you decide to purchase the G500, or any private jet for that matter, another way to manage costs is to outsource the operations and maintenance of the fleet.
So just for a bird's eye view, investing in an aircraft is a pretty big deal. It's like forming your own company to do this. So what we do as a service is that we offer management services, and this way you can mitigate and fix all your costs so that you don't have any surprises along the way. Because once you own an aircraft, that's when you start thinking, okay, now I have to pay for fuel. Next, I have to hangar it, and then I have to get the permits for the flight. So many things happen which do not deserve your time. You are a titan of industry. Maybe 10 minutes of your time is worth 10 million pesos. Our company, Asian Aerospace, can easily manage it for you so that you don't have to deal with these little things that cause so much headaches, and in turn, you just arrive, come to your flight, and go.
Indeed, it hasn't been as simple, convenient, and safe to travel for business in over 2 years, whether it's flying to your destination or staying at a hotel. Business travel is back, and maybe even better.